If you've watched any of my previous videos, then you know that I am so proud to be gay. I wouldn't change it for the world. I love myself for the way that I am, and I'm so grateful for all of the friends that I've made. I'm also incredibly grateful for my boyfriend, but more on that later. But there's always a but. There are aspects of being gay that truly just suck. Not literally, but figuratively. Today, I'm going to give you guys 7 reasons why being gay is sometimes the worst. This is my honest opinion. Emphasis on my opinion. Please feel free to comment below and share your opinion. My goal with these videos is to create an ongoing, realistic, and healthy conversation about gay culture. Just to prove to you guys that I actually do like being gay, I have this beautiful little rainbow Tumbler right here for all you gay dog dads, and I actually got a matching phone case. So, yes, I love being gay, but I'm also going to talk about the worst parts about being gay today. I'll leave the links to those in the description below. Again, I love being gay, but today I'm feeling a little frisky and realistic, so let's get into it. The worst parts about being gay, in no particular order. First, we have beauty standards in the gay community. The gay community is incredibly exclusive when it comes to looks. There's some expectation that gay men are supposed to be perfect, shredded men. If you don't fit that mold, then unfortunately, you're at a disadvantage socially. What's crazy about this is that gay men are already excluded by the rest of society, yet gays themselves are excluding other gays based on looks. Gay guys definitely objectify each other based on looks. Go on any gay website or gay influencer Instagram account, and you'll find a lot of perfect, shredded, beautiful men, usually white men, very few minorities, unfortunately. The pressure to be good looking, stylish, and fit is always there in the gay community. People that don't fit this mold have it the hardest. There are people that believe tops and bottoms should physically look a certain way. Masculine men sometimes think that feminine men look too feminine. It's ridiculous and honestly unhealthy. Okay, rant over, it just upsets me. The next reason why being gay is the worst is the hookup culture within the gay community. I feel like a lot of people in the gay community are more interested in hooking up and having sex than actually forming friendships or even long-term relationships. Lots of gays get into this vicious cycle of always wanting the next best thing. There's this joke within the gay community that you hook up with somebody and then they become your friend. Like a rite of passage. I personally don't really like that. You think you finally made a good friend and then they want to have sex with you. Gay hookup culture will definitely hinder your ability to form genuine relationships or find somebody that's looking for a long-term relationship. However, it's definitely possible to find good friends and find somebody looking for a long-term relationship. It is just more difficult to do so, in my opinion. Jeez, I am going off on the gay community today, but I am so sorry. On to the next. Another reason why being gay is the worst is the community itself is so small. The gay community in most cities is just tiny. Not only is the dating pool small, but if you have an ex-boyfriend that lives in the same city as you, you're most likely going to run into them quite often. One of the reasons why I moved from Denver to Miami was because I was seeing my ex-boyfriends almost everywhere that I went: gay bars, gay events, gay volleyball league. And it was just not healthy for me. I had to remove myself, and I'm so glad that I did. Either way, the gay community is very small, and I feel like people know all about you before you even meet them. You run into the same people quite often. This can be good and bad depending on how you look at it. My next reason why being gay is sometimes the worst is having to come out more than once. I thought that when I came out as gay years ago, that would be the first and last time that I would ever have to come out. Girl, you were so wrong. As an openly gay person, you'll most likely have to come out to future friends, coworkers, people you meet on the street. You might have to awkwardly come out to girls at bars when they try to flirt with you. That's my personal hell. I'm a proud Gold Star gay. So unfortunately, until this world becomes less heteronormative, you're probably going to have to come out more than once. However, it does get easier each time you do it, so that's a plus. My fifth reason why being gay is sometimes the worst is general homophobia and discrimination. Every gay person experiences it at least once in their life. People cast you aside and hate you for no reason. Straight people make laws that put you at a disadvantage. You don't feel safe everywhere you go, especially in more conservative parts of town or more conservative parts of the country. You may lose friends because you're gay, or you may lose relationships with family members. It just sucks, and there's no way to sugarcoat it. There will be a select group of people that stay by your side, and that's a good part of the LGBTQ community. You learn to choose people that choose you. My next reason why being gay is sometimes the worst is the mental health issues that come with being gay. You spend a long period of your life living a lie, and it's hard to cope with that. For me, I have what seems like PTSD from going so many years hiding this big secret that I was gay. It caused me so much stress and so much anxiety. You can also become very lonely as a gay person. Sometimes it's difficult to have a genuine connection with somebody in the gay community. As I mentioned earlier, it's just super small, and some people just want to have sex. Situations like these can lead to anxiety and depression. Being gay has definitely led me to be more empathetic towards others, but that is because I don't want anybody to have to go through the trauma that I went through as a gay person. My last reason why I think being gay is sometimes the worst is the gay party scene. Most of gay social life revolves around drinking and drugs. In most cities, the most common place to congregate with other gay people is at a bar, a gay bar. There are pros and cons to this, of course. Gay men like to have fun, I'll give them that. On the other hand, a lot of friendships that you develop are just drunk friendships. What I mean by this is you're only friends with somebody when you're drunk, or they're drunk, or you're drunk at the same time at a gay bar. For me, this just makes for a lot of surface-level discussions. I know a lot of gay men that have a drinking and/or drug problem that stems directly from the gay party scene. It's sad to see, and that's why I recommend seeking additional ways to congregate with other gay men that don't involve being under the influence, like gay groups or gay sports leagues. I'm in no way against partying at a gay club every once in a while. I do it, we all do it, it's okay. But it can become toxic if you do it constantly. All right, those are my seven reasons why being gay is sometimes the worst. I'm sorry about being so negative today. I'm usually positive about being gay, and I truly love being gay. I wouldn't trade it for the world, like I said earlier. But I also want to be realistic about the gay community so I can inform others, teach others about what it's actually like to be gay and live in the gay community. Thank you guys so much for watching until the end of this video. If you could remember to like and subscribe, that would help out the channel a bunch. I'm really grateful for all of you, and I love reading your comments. Please remember to wear sunscreen and listen to Taylor Swift. I'm actually wearing my Taylor Swift Eras Tour shirt right now, if you haven't noticed. But regardless, I hope everybody has a fantastic, safe day, and remember to live your best life and just be yourself. Until next time, peace out.